Now I'd like to show you a quick and easy way to make mailing labels out of your access data. Now some of you use the mail merge tool in Microsoft Word, which is great. That can use access data, but we can actually make mailing labels right from access. So let's say we have this table over here. We have the customers table, right? And of course we have the customer ID and company name and the address and everything like that. Well, we'd like to make nice labels from there. So watch how easily we can do that. We're going to pick on the create menu. Now what you want to do is you just click on your table first. In other words, you pick the table from which you want to make your labels first. Then you pick on create. Then if you notice over here, there's one that's called labels. Okay. The first thing that you're going to pick is your label size. Now, the ones that I'm familiar with would be the unit of measure equals English. The label type usually is going to be sheet feed. If you have a laser jet printer or a desk jet printer, it's going to be sheet feed. Now, if you have one of those printers that have, the paper that rolls up, then it would be continuous feed. But you don't really see those too much anymore. However, I've seen companies that still have those to print their labels because they have so many labels. So that still could be a possibility. But a lot of us are just using the sheet feed. Now, the ones that I'm familiar with are over here where it says filter by manufacturer. When you click on that pull down, quite frankly, the only ones I've actually used are Avery labels. And these are just different manufacturers or labels. But the Avery labels you can purchase at Office Max or Staples. And those are really popular. So let's pick on Avery. And then up here, it's going to show you all of the Avery product numbers. So, you know, you can go to Office Max or Staples. And, you know, they would sell a lot of these, I'm sure. Now, a really popular one is called 5160. And 5160 is your standard address label. So I'm just going to use that, but any one of these would work just fine. So we'll pick on next. Now, here it's asking you for the font and the font size and the color of the label. I don't usually change that here because I don't even know what the label looks like yet. We could change that here, but we'll have another opportunity to change that later on. So I usually just skip that screen. I'm going to pick on next. Okay. Now in this screen, it wants you to build a prototype label. Imagine what your prototype label is going to look like. On the first line, we would have the name. The second line, we would have the address. And then the third line, we have the city, state, and zip, you know, just as an example. So you're going to use your fields to build your prototype label. On the first line, I'm going to double click on the company name and notice how that wound up in my prototype label. To go to the next line, I'm just going to hit the enter key on the keyboard, or I can just click on the second line. Either way is fine. We'll use the address on the second line, so I'll double click on that. I'm going to click on the third line of the label, and on the third line, I'm going to double click on the city. Now, between the city and the state, I'm going to have a comma and a space, so I just type that in. Now, the state here is called region because some of them are international, so I'll double click on a region, and then I'll hit another space between that and the postal code, and I'll double click on postal code. So your label can be any combination of your fields. And then when you want to go to the next line, you just click on the next line. And we can also type information in there as well. Okay. So let's say in this case, we'll pick on next. This screen is asking you if you'd like to sort your labels. Let's say we're going to sort it by country. And then by postal code within country. Because at least here in the United States, if you have your mail sorted by the postal code, if you have enough mail, you bring that down to the post office, you might get a little bit of a discount because it's sorted by postal code. So we'll do that. I'll sort it by country and then by postal code. We'll pick on next. And now we're done with the wizard, actually. Let's pick on finish. With this wizard, every time I run this, I always get this message. It's just a warning, so you don't really have to worry about it. Just click on OK. And just like that, in less than 5 minutes, we were able to build labels out of our customer's table. And all we did there was the label wizard. So notice how it printed the name of the company, the address, the city. In this case, I guess it had a second line of address, but it overlapped. But here we have the name of the company, the address, the city. Now, some of them don't have a region because it's international, but this one has a region, as you can see, and then it has the postal code. So just like that, in less than a couple minutes, we were able to build our labels using the label wizard. If we printed that, that would fit perfectly on that label size that we chose, which in this case was the 5160. I'm going to close that window, and now we have beautiful labels. If I scroll down, you're going to see this is a report that I made in a previous example, and then here's the labels that we just made. By the way, when we change the table, then the reports get updated automatically. And as a matter of fact, when we change the table, the queries get updated automatically, and so do the forms. Everything kind of comes from the table. But that's a quick and easy way to make labels using Microsoft Access, the Label Wizard.